Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today we are doing another piercing related video, and as you can tell by the title, this video is going to be, do I still clean my piercings after they're healed? And that is a very good question. That is a question I get a lot on my channel. That is a question I get a lot in my personal life. People ask me, hey, your piercings are awesome. Like, do you still have to clean them though? Or when they're healed, are you like good to go? That's just kind of a question I'm gonna be going over in this video, because I feel like everyone's different and everyone's body is different. So when it comes to certain piercings and when it comes to certain like body types or things like that, like for instance, for me, every time I go and get a piercing, it does kind of take a little bit for my body to kind of heal and adjust to it. So I feel like this question is kind of all dependent on the person. Let me know down in the comments if you guys still clean your piercings after they're healed. I would love to know what you guys do to take care of yours, keep them nice and fresh and all that good stuff, or do you not do anything at all? So to answer everybody's question, do I still clean my piercings after they're healed? The answer is yes, I do. I definitely do still clean my piercings for sure, but probably not to the extent that you're thinking. I definitely have a couple different ways that I do them, and of course, if I have a piercing that is infected, I do have my own little treatment plan of doing that as well for sure. Now, I don't do this very often, maybe a couple times a week, or maybe, you know, every 3 weeks or once a month. It really kind of all depends. I do notice that I do have to do this more in the summertime, just because, you know, I'm sweating. Sand from the beach, dirty water from the lake, you know, anything like that. So the way I like to see it is, even though your piercings are healed, even though, like, you know, they've been there for years, they're doing fine, there's absolutely no issues with them, they are still in fact foreign objects in your body, and you do still have to care for them and treat them like they're foreign objects in your body, because, well, that's what they are. So they should definitely be cleaned, they should definitely be checked on every once in a while, you know, make sure there's nothing goofy going on with them, or, you know, any weird colored liquids coming out of them, you know what I'm saying? I'm sorry if this is TMI, okay? I'm just getting into the real dirty guts of the piercing world. So yeah, that's just the way I like to see it, is even though they are healed, it's still a foreign object in your body. It's still an object that was not there when you were born. So you really just kind of want to make sure and keep it clean. I find this especially sure for ear piercings. I do have a significant amount of ear piercings. I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I have 8 in this ear, and I have 1, 2, 3, 4, and I have 7 in this ear. So I, out of everywhere else on my body, my ears are definitely the most populated with piercings. And the number one thing is, make sure for sure you are cleaning your ear piercings. If you have ever stretched your ears, if you have ever gone a while without washing your jewelry or anything like that, or you go to change your jewelry, you're gonna notice a certain kind of funk. If you're someone who's ever stretched your ears, you know exactly the funk I'm talking about. That is your clear as fuck sign to clean your piercings and or your jewelry. I like to do both, and I will get more in depth on how I do that. This doesn't go for everybody. This goes for more people like me, or people who do get cheaper body jewelry. Now, you know what they say, good is expensive, cheap is bad. That's just the saying, and I do get that, I understand it. I have had my bad brush with bad body jewelry before. So every time I do clean my piercings, I do examine the jewelry. I make sure that there's no, you know, any, you know, tarnishing or missing gems or anything like that. If it does, I do throw it away. But that's just something, if you are going to buy cheaper body jewelry, I don't see anything wrong with it. I have always bought cheap body jewelry. I've never had an issue with it. But I do always like to make sure, because you never, never know. So whenever you are cleaning your piercings, you know, check the smell, check the actual piercing site itself. Is there any redness, anything, you know, something that is not of the ordinary? Is there any pain? And definitely check the body jewelry as well. And again, some piercings, even years down the line, like I've said, you know, ear piercings or nipple piercings or cheek piercings, those are like the top three I can think of off the top of my head. Even years down the line, they still run the risk of, you know, getting crusty or not healing well, or, you know, just all the yucky stuff. So sometimes those need to be cleaned more often than others, like say a nose piercing that you've had for 7 years. So the way I take care of my piercings and the way I clean my piercings, which all of the piercings that I do have on my body currently are 100% healed. So the first way is, if I'm doing like a full jewelry change or I'm doing a little bit more of a deeper clean, I will go through and I will remove every single piece of body jewelry. The only one I do not remove is my Daith piercing, because that that one, the jewelry is literally bent in that shape, so I'd have to literally like unbend it, so I don't remove that one. Or if I do have like a new or healing piercing, I leave those in as well. But if I'm doing like a more deeper clean, I will remove all of my piercings and I will wash the actual body jewelry and I will wash the body part separately with antibacterial soap. Now, I just get this from the grocery store. This is just a soft soap. I used to use this to heal my belly button piercing. I've been using this stuff for years. No complaints about it. I really do like it. Or you can use Dial soap, but be careful with that because that can be a little bit on the drying side, so just keep an eye on your piercings then. But I will wash the body jewelry in the sink very carefully, and then I will wash the actual body part with antibacterial soap. Now, if I'm just doing a quick clean in the shower, I will just leave the jewelry in. I will pump a little bit of this in my hands, get it up to a nice lather, and I will wash the jewelry like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm just kidding. Make sure that you are washing your hands first before you do that though. So I will wash my hands with this and then I will put a separate pump in my hand afterward and clean all of my piercings. This is the one that I do keep in my shower. I highly recommend that you do get one of these and keep it in your shower. Another really good soap that I want to recommend to you guys is the Provon Antimicrobial Soap. You can get it on Amazon. I haven't got it in years just because I can't ever find the time to get on my computer and order it for some reason, but that is also a really good option. I use that for years as well on all my piercings. And then the only other time I really kind of wash my jewelry in depth is if I'm having a sort of flare-up or infection, and for that I will use my sea salt. Now, you guys have been seeing this on my channel since about 2012. I've been using the same exact sea salt for literally 6 years now. It is my tried and true, my ride or die. I love this stuff. Make sure that you are using non-iodized sea salt to clean your piercings. Do a quick internet search, look for non-iodized sea salt. That is the best thing for your piercings because it doesn't have all those additives and all that other stuff. I will use this if I'm having an infection or a flare up on any of my piercings. I will do sea salt soak, sea salt paste, whatever I need to do. Okay guys, and that is everything that I have for this video. Hopefully this video was helpful and informational for those of you, and for those of you who do have a ton of piercings but don't really know how to clean them all at the same time, or you don't know what the easiest way is. Hopefully this video gave you a little bit of an idea of what I do and what I personally use. If you guys did in fact enjoy this video, make sure you go down and hit the thumbs up button. It really does help me out a lot. And if you are new to my channel, make sure you go down and subscribe so you don't miss out on any future videos. But as always, I will see you guys very, very soon in my next one. I love you guys. Bye.